Welcome to New Hampshire's Business. I'm Fred Coker. It's rare that the Chambers of Commerce in New Hampshire are at loggerheads over an economic issue. Well, they are over the Northern Pass electric transmission line, and here it is coming from the Canadian border 180 miles down through New Hampshire to its terminus in Deerfield, bringing hopefully 1,200 megawatts of electricity from Hydro-Quebec and the promise of cheaper and cleaner energy. At least that's the promise. But there are differences among the chambers, and here they are. Supporting the project are the Manchester, Nashville, Rochester chambers, opposing are the Littleton and Plymouth chambers. Considering a position are the Lincoln and North Country chambers, and no position at the moment, Berlin, Mount Washington Valley, and Laconia chambers. With me to talk about this are two people on opposite sides of this issue, but who really get along. They're good friends. Chris Williams, the president of the Greater Nashville Chamber of Commerce.
Good morning.
Nice to have you here. And Will Abbott, the vice president for public policy at the Society for the Protection of New Hampshire Forests. Welcome.
Thank you,
Nice
Fred.
To have you here. Will, those chambers up north, I know I tried to get some of the opposing chambers to come in and sit here. They didn't want to do it, and I understand. But you've talked to them, and what are their concerns?
Well, I've actually talked to a number of chambers. In fact, Chris kindly invited me to talk to the Nashua Chamber back a year and a half ago, and probably been to a dozen of them since, about this subject. And I think that New Hampshire isn't one big economy. It's a lot of small economies. And what you're seeing is these chambers in different parts of the state are reflecting the communities that they serve and the priorities that those communities see in an issue like this.
Well, here's one Plymouth. The Plymouth Chamber is one of the chambers opposed. They put out a press release, and here are two of the items that were in that press release. The project will negatively impact the tourism industry upon which our region heavily depends, directly and indirectly, as it will irreparably scar the area's iconic natural beauty. And then this, there are no guarantees that this imported power will lower electric rates in New Hampshire. Now, Chris, the Nashua Chamber supports this. Why?
We have a board of directors and an advocacy committee, both of which are comprised of roughly 45 different companies, not all of which are actually located in Nashua. Many of them are outside in the southern New Hampshire area. We are all looking at the energy market and the extremely high rates that we are having to pay here for power versus the other parts of the country. And we see no end in sight for that. You look at what's happening with natural gas prices right now is just one example of the lack of diversity and the high prices that New England has to pay compared to the rest of the country. That is why we are concerned that the Northern Pass should get due diligence by the federal and state governments and move forward if it is found to be in the best interest of our state.
Will, what's the key to the opposition here from your organization?
I think from the Forest Society's standpoint, this isn't about whether the power itself is desirable. It's about how we're bringing the power to market. And in our view, as the Plymouth Chamber suggested in their position statement, you know, the economies of central and northern New Hampshire are heavily dependent on the landscape. And if you scar the landscape, you scar the economy. And that's why you're seeing these chambers in the central and northern part of the state oppose Northern Pass. So it really is about the economy as well as the landscape. They're integrated.
Do you think, Chris, I'm going to ask both of you this, do you think this is really going to be built at the end of the day? Is there going to be an accommodation somewhere along the way?
I'm optimistic that when all is said and done, the federal, the site evaluation committee will take a look at this, and Northern Pass officials will come together with those on the other side of the issue, and we will see a project that moves forward in some form or fashion.
How about that, Will? Same question.
I don't think the project will ever be built as 180 miles of above ground towers, 90 to 135 feet in the air. I think if there's ever going to be an accommodation, they'll figure out a way to get their power to market without creating that scar on the New Hampshire
Perhaps
landscape.
Burying those lines, and that's the just my comment.
Yeah, that could be a win-win from the state's perspective.
Will Abbott, Vice President for Policy at the Society for the Protection of New Hampshire Forests, and Chris Williams, President and CEO of the Nashua Chamber of Commerce. Thanks. You can see this interview again at WMUR.com. Go to News and then click on Project Economy.